And hello, welcome to Foot Manager 2016 with Portsmouth. And here you can see my transfers. Just gonna just dive right into it, showing you the table later. Nathan Bacon needed a defender, got him in. Decent little player. From Aston Villa, got Valera on a loan. He likes to be suspended. I played a few seasons on. I signed him in a free square. Damn, does he ever like getting sent off and getting yellow and suspended. Yeah, then Jessica Foster-Kowski from last season, in back on the free, doing good, you know, it's gonna feature for this season to go on, maybe not the biggest or bigger role, but who knows, who really knows. And then Jesse, you don't need an okay striker, I don't really need a striker, I think, because I got really good wingers who do the stuff for me, but yeah, he's doing... Still gonna again spoil him, bring him on a free. Because, you know, I needed a striker. Literally. And if you have watched other videos, and also Jawa Carlos, not a Liverpool player. It's basically because it was free. Because I know who he is, because I'm a Liverpool supporter, but you know, he's decent for this level, you know. Not because I'm a Liverpool, but I'm bringing in this Liverpool because yes, I remember a few years ago was good in the championship. So that did good last season year in the championship. No Valera, you know, play him. I don't think it's bringing him because it's a good right back. Yeah, these people that they don't matter. They literally matter because I didn't get paid anything for them, so that means automatically they can't matter. That's logic. So yeah, and last season I said when I got promoted, I want to take it slow, but my players really don't listen to me. And yeah, I don't know how this happened. I was expecting this to be incredibly hard. I was expecting to be here, but somehow my players wanted to do good, and they like. I wish I could tell to them we don't need to be this fast. And Jack Stubbs is. He's gone, literally. He's gone, and here you can see the place, you know, with the SL. The team is unhappy, everyone's unhappy, you know. And yeah, I can see Connor Shepherd has been doing really good too. Yeah, it's, even though he's been out quite a lot, Foskakowski has been doing good for me. The midfield is doing good too. We got the defense with love, and Chris Walton, of course, for another season on loan, doing. Okay, might need a new goalie next year, who knows? That's sort of a little broken. And yeah, what's funny is that Sheffield Wednesday is in the Premier League. So I could loan Stoke back. Yeah, that's fun for me. But let's go to the game Stoke. And yeah, had a great start to the season. Didn't expect to win here at all. But yeah, Jack Stubbs getting to an Adam Barton they wanted different. You know, won the first round of the Monk Cup, 3-2, against Leighton, Orient, 2 goals by Jesper and a own goal, I'm gonna guess. McDonald's got beaten 2-0. Gary Robertson, Jesper. Then a real good draw in my opinion. Matt Tubbs getting a goal in a 1-1 draw. Then another good draw, I think, you know, for the, I guess, at least then. I guess the good Fulham team, you know, I think they've been going up and down. Yeah. So yeah, 1-1. Jack Stubbs getting goal. Lost against Stoke away, which is a good result. You don't hear me saying that there are a lot of good results here. No, Bristol City we should have beaten. Yeah, if they're Bristol City, you know, they're not that good, to be honest. No, in real life, though, because I mean, in real life, if not wrong, fighting relegation, you know. Could check that very fast. Let's check it very fast. It's like I never took a break. Yeah, they're 22nd right now in real life. To the 28th of December. I'm recording a few. I'm recording two seasons now because I can't be bothered to record later. 1-1. 3-1 and a real good 3-1 away win. Didn't even get to use my favorite best goalie then. Had to use Brian Murphy. Jake Foster-Kowski getting a goal and Connor Chaplin going in the 2. Then another brilliant win. But no, is it? Aren't they struggling? I don't know. My team does better than I think it is. My team is better than I think it is. Jack Stubbs has an own goal there. Then home win. Valera getting goal. I think he got... Oh, he didn't get a yellow card. That's unheard of for me. Yeah, I can see yellow. Not playing. Yellow. Wow. You're gonna see it in the next season to him. Like, I need... In the end... Where I'm right now, I just signed another Raptor because I can't be bothered. And of course, that Raptor, you can got in it for 3 months. Great. First of all, so pissed off in getting sent off half of the, like, 10% of the time, you know, not being able to selection. 1-1 against Huddersfield, 1-1. Yes, look at him goal, and but Gary Roberts, Pendy's a Huddersfield fan, giving him a goal. Gary Roberts, no. Wolves, we actually play them. Gary Roberts. Sorry. But yeah, Gary Roberts actually scored then, and Connor Shepard making off it. 1-5. Great win there. Great win. Texera getting all 5 goals. No, we lost terribly, but wasn't too bothered. 1-1 against Hull. Webster getting a goal. Reading, 1-0. Stockley, 2-2 against Burst. No, against... Wow, I'm brain farting all over now. It's not him. Burst and a non-goal, helping us them. Then a really good win. 3-1 against something. Jack Stubbs, CSL and Connor Chaplin. Then I 1-0 loss. Finally we lost at home. You know, this is how this is the game against Cardiff. I thought this division was gonna be like, you know, not that easy. We lost, which I'm semi happy about. 3-3, Jack Stubbs getting 2 and Danny Hollands coming and scoring them. 2-0 loss against Wigan. Then, you know, making me believe again, I don't know what, I still don't believe as of here, though I played on, I'm not gonna spoil it, but we're gonna end high up, but at this point, when I played, I did not believe I was gonna end up as high as I did. That's a very good way to phrase it, I'm gonna applaud that phrasing. Ender Stevenson getting a goal and Jack Stubbs getting a hat-trick. 1-1 against Wassel. Jack Stubbs scoring, you know, it's Jack Stubbs' show. Foster Kalski and Gary Roberts getting goals in a 2-1 brilliant win against Leeds. And then a 2-0 loss against Sunderland. A lot of yellow cards. Birmingham, 1-1. Jack Stubbs getting another goal because he can. Then we have a game against Sheffield United. Matt Tubbs getting 2, but of course, Jack Stubbs scoring again. Jack Stubbs scoring another 2 goals, Connor Shepling getting a goal, and Samu Diesel scoring in the 4-1 game against Middlesbrough at home. 2-1 against MK Dons. 2 own goals, you know, because Jack Stubbs. Look, I'm gonna venture to guess that he had an assist, yeah. He just has to be involved. You know, Jack Stubbs is my. Messi, yeah. This is good at my Messi, you know, he does have everything in him. Somebody has really getting golden 1-0 win against Derby. Fulham, 2-0 loss, not that bothered. 2-1 win against Bristol. Jack Stubbs and Jaden Stockley. Jack Stubbs again scoring, you know, are you surprised? Then, very good 2-1 loss against Everton with 2 people sent off, including of course Gudimero Varela. I think it says in this fucking report that Tennessee, yeah, has a competitive streak, which can occasionally lead to him bending the rules. I'm putting like quotation mark around occasionally because he gets a yellow card every fucking game, it seems like. So yeah, I guess I can show you the whole league looks at that total. In a second, I'm gonna turn down the volume in front of the music. But if you haven't figured it out yet, I will listen to music when I do this because, yeah, it's easier. And yeah, if I sometimes don't talk, it's because I'm looking for a song. Let's listen to that one. I'm gonna, yeah. Go down first. We're gonna look in the sky between one Charlton and Fleetwood. It's fighting there. With Morecambe, Southend, Oldham and Doncaster. I remember these teams. Not at all. I don't remember. For Scarlet League 2, that was a good league. for us. Yeah, we own that. And yeah, what's funny is just find a team above us. And yeah, it's nice having a team above you, not being, you know, losing. You forgot that. It's a good feeling. Then, this is the league, you know, not anything shocking there. Except Bokvot, where I would expect them to do better. 1-1. No, they lost in the last minute, didn't they? Against Tottenham. With that song flick thingy. Yeah, good team. QPR, Norwich, Sheffield Wednesday. Aston Villa being surprisingly high up. Ha! Huh. And Newcastle being surprisingly high up too. And Liverpool. And Everton. Ha ha! And Bournemouth. Ha! I'm making fun of all the teams. And Chelsea. I said, awesome or something. Oh, and Man City. They probably have a player from Spain. Where Real Madrid plays. And they play in the Liga BBVA. BBVA. I don't know. La Liga. Let's just call it La Liga. Never heard of this team. Never seen the Lenganes. Never heard of them. I'll be honest, you know, because. You know, teams. I don't know. I don't really follow the Spanish league too much. I just know, look at the positions at the end of the season. I'm not that big a fan of the Spanish league, actually, surprisingly. I like to watch the German because that's what's on television for me. Free. Because of Jürgen Klopp. Yeah. Bayern plays there. They're probably first. The sixth! Wow. Yeah. English start from March. I gotta see Luke and I guess. I don't know if it's surprising high up. I don't know if it has been struggling last season, haven't they? Signed Ivo Fossum from Strømsgodset. So don't. I'm gonna rant a little. I don't get why you would leave a Norwegian top club to play for a team that fighting relegation in the German first division. It was for like. I don't know. Team. You didn't fight for relegation last season, you know, which would be okay. But, you know, or going down to the second division would be okay too. Though you wouldn't still get that, you know, you're playing for a team that plays the Europa League, and you could show yourself more and get signed by a big club. So you're gonna go to a smaller club who, you know, could also work as a stepping stone, but not as much really, I think personally. Because if you're in a team that does good, it makes you seem better. If you're a team that does bad, it's gonna make you seem worse. Usually. That's also maybe a mistake that. Well, but you can make. I understand that Norwegian. Well, another example is, you know, my father dad, who was. He's a big talent, he's only 20 years old or something. I think he's 1 year older than me. No, he's as old as me. Oh. Yeah, you know, but yeah, I don't say he made a mistake because he got injured and I wasn't gonna get used to Cardiff and they, I don't know, it's a hard thing to say with those sort of transfers, but it would have more sense going to a team slightly higher up the table when they played for such a good team in the Norwegian League. If you played for like Start or Vålerenga or one of those teams, yeah, they're both old shit. Everything under 30 is a shit for me. No way, no, listen, but yeah, that's really. Sometimes sidings don't make sense. Let's just say that. And this is the team. I guess I could go and show the stats overall. Let's look at goals. Got Dagstob surprisingly leading with. Yes, in the second, when I assist, we have Valera, who, even though missing half of the games this season, has most assists. And then we have most games, of course, Christian Walton, but it's not anything more I can call it now, so I'm gonna end it, then go ahead and get right on recording. I'm gonna show you something behind the scenes here. Wow, I have played so far, this is where we are now. I have played so far, ooh. Look at all these saves. Ooh. Ooh. This is the save where I took over I went then there, and then now I'm here. I'm gonna be the first season and I don't know. What's a Newcastle one? This is turning into me looking at my stage. I'm gonna do a regular, that's a hard word. But I haven't decided yet, and you know it's a lot more work doing it. This is to get me back into video making before I, you know, start doing it more professionally. You know, I'm doing what I did in the start, and then I started editing, and then I'm gonna start editing soon again when I do. Not classical stuff, because editing classical doesn't make sense to me, because basically I'm not gonna use facecam here, because you know it sort of ruins it for me, you know, having a face there sort of ruins it. If anyone wants a facecam, I'll put it in, but nobody ever comments and or watches this video, so hey, I can say whatever I want. But yeah, that's the end of the episode. If you liked it, like it. If you didn't like it, dislike it. If you want to follow this series or any other series I do, subscribe, and yeah, bye.